hard time.
I got angry and went out on a
Thursday night. Helen is the host. Frank works out to me. Jane teaches grade school and probably college school. Bob works for the city. Jackson laughs at me. Peggy plays the organ at Preston to enter. And the class of 57 has changed. We all thought we'd change the world with our great work. Maybe we just thought the world change the fit our need. Class of 57 has changed. I graduated in 67. Betty runs the trailer park. Jan sells the Tupperware. Randy's on an insane world, Mary's on welfare. Charlie took the job before Joseph, Freddie's wife. Charlie took the million hell, Freddie took his life. Johnny's big heart, Ray, maybe find a wind up in anybody's bed. Linda married Sonny, Brenda married me. And the class of all of us is just part of history. And the class of 67 had a dream. We're living lives day to day, never like the same. Things are kind of crazy, and we get it crazy again. Class of 57 had a scream. Oh, the class of 57 had a scream.
Yeah.
That's a good little song.
Got a lot of words in it, ain't it?
Yeah, I had. It's tough to learn that line. I learned it. I should have did it while ago.
Yeah.
It took me a long time to learn that.
What's the first country song?
I'll tell you another one.
You always ask them trivia questions. What's the first country song Tom Jones done?
Bring Green Grass to Home? Let's see.
Biggest settler ever had at that point in his career.
And it wasn't the Green Green Grass.
Say You'll Stay Until Tomorrow.
Oh, really? Ah, John Schneider did that, didn't he?
They may have lost it. I'm not first.
Okay.
One time in my life.
I sang it 7 8. And it was the biggest song you'd ever done. Biggest seller part. It was a million seller part.
I feel that.
Yeah.
Get up no more. It's down the street. Never felt it.
That song there, you're supposed to be talking at first part of it.
I can't
pay check on the low violin.
Yeah, I believe you're talking, yeah.
Huh?
Yeah, you're talking.
It don't tell you on there that what part you're talking, what part you're
tonight play, I see.
It's ring that on track.
Yeah.
Like
you gotta really
violin.
Know the song to know when to talk and when to sing it.
Right.
Kind of like the
soon to be put away.
Patches that I tried to do on.
Never play again.
Yeah. It tells you when to talk and when to sing it. But that's a damn fast. You try to do the talking part, then it starts singing part of it. If I learn all of it, if I ever do it for you, it wouldn't matter where you wasn't trying to keep up with the screen. Sing it like you can sing it.
Just
yep.
Hardest thing I've ever fought.
Have you ever heard Colorado Kool-Aid?
Yeah. Johnny Baker.
He got it on there. I won't do it Thursday night. He's got it on the floor.
I'm still looking for them songs, man. I'll find it.
That Colorado Kool-Aid, I like the way those Jimmy Joe, he'll download that thing after he did some Hank Williams. I like to knock the hell out of him.
Where do you go from here? In like a fruit.
He's talking that third verse, he's trying to talk the first.
There
I was seeing an old violin. Soon be put away, never play again. So one more time. I said, John, where in the hell do you go? You know the one in the middle of the difference? I turned around and there I was seeing an old violin.
Another week when my daughter-in-law done with that song with Keith Urban here in the woods, you done left hand.
I've been
the fighter?
Mm-hmm.
I know it was no woman over there that fight Friday night. So Don Nelson comes over here and told me, where the hell have you been doing that damn song? He done that in a few damn times.
That's good. He's buried right next to George Jones.
Huh?
He's buried right beside George Jones.
Yeah.
George gave him his plot right next to him.
Yeah.
That's that wonderful, because he didn't have nowhere to be buried. And George gave him his plot right beside him. That's good in George doing that. He's buried right beside George Jones. George gave him the plot. See, he died for George. And George gave him that plot, and when they buried George, George is buried right beside him. They were good buddies, you know.
Johnny paid that, didn't have enough
money to burn. George gave him the grave lot.
Yeah.
I was good at him.
I mean, that's something.
So, yeah.
Right then in the song, you painted up your lips and rolled and curled your tinted hair. Ruby, are you contemplating going out somewhere?
Mel Tillis, okay. Mel Tillis,
tells me the sun is going down.
Kenny Rogers did it. Mel Tillis wrote it.
Oh, Ruby. Don't take your love back.
Earl Thomas Conway, they all wrote a lot of songs.
But oh, yeah.
It wasn't me that started that old crazy.
Then with the Bellamy's on it, and
I was crying, going to my
song. Oh, baby, what we say, y'all, Jimmy?
Yes, it's true. That
I made out of 12 on
the
CD.
Oh, yeah.
And Earl Thomas Conway. He wrote and co-wrote about everything
he wrote. He did. He was a good writer.
I still need some company.
Gee, what?
It's
never
hard
to love
a man whose legs have been paralyzed.
Well, Elvis Russell that time, C.C. Reiner.
He didn't write no harder, did he?
And the wants and the needs of a woman your age really are realized.
And in themselves, where's the shit?
Won't be hard to word and say until I'm not around. Oh, Ruby, are you take your love to town?
Oh, Jerry asked me that week.
She's leaving town,
because
I just heard a slam in the door.
Man.
You bet you didn't mind leaving me, Lucille. You start doing this damn song.
Yeah.
The gambling, you bet you didn't mind leaving me.
I could get my gun and put her in the ground. Oh, Ruby, don't take your love to town. Oh, Ruby,
mama, don't be
Jay Thomas. I know it, but I ain't never done it.
For God's sakes,
that's the hardest song I've done to do.
Yeah, it is.
The hardest one's me doing, not crying when I'm singing it.
Mm-hmm. So you know Tillis wrote it? Yeah. Mel Tillis wrote that.
Kenny Rogers.
Me, I was telling him Mel Tillis wrote that.
Did he?
Yeah.
How about this one? Jerry Reed.
Oh, he probably wrote that.
Probably.
He writes about all his songs.
Well, I guess it was back in 63 when he and my cookie got the better of me, so I asked this little girl I was going with to be my wife. Well, she said she would, so I said I do, but I said I wouldn't if I'm just you. How saying I do was going to screw it all my life. Well, the first few years weren't all that bad. I'll never forget the good times we had, because I reminded every month when I sent her to child support. Well, it wasn't too long till the lust all died, and I admit I wasn't too surprised. Today I come home and found my suitcase sitting on the porch.
Old fella.
Tried to call and she checked the lock. Then I found this note taped over the mailbox and said, "Goodbye, turkey. My attorney will be here too." So I signed right then and there. I was going to do what the right give her for her share. But rather, I didn't know her share was going to be that much. She got the gold mine. I got the shaft. And they split right down the middle. And then they gave her the better half. Well, it all sounds sort of funny, but it hurts too much to laugh. She got the gold mine. I got the shaft. Now listen, you ain't heard nothing yet. They gave her the color television set, and then they gave her the house, the kids, and both the cars. See, well, let's start talking about child support, alimony, and the cost of court. Didn't take me long to figure out how far in the toilet I was. I'm telling you, that's made a mistake, because it adds up to more than this cowboy makes. Besides, everything I was worth taking, I already took. Well, she's living like a queen on alimony. I'm working two shifts eating bologna, asking myself, why didn't you just learn how to cook? They gave her the gold mine. They gave me the shaft. They said to sit down right in the middle, but she's got the better half. Well, it all sounds kind of funny, but it hurts too much for that. She got the gold mine. I got the shaft. I get tickled just doing that.
Been doing that from being upstairs and doing it hard. I can tell.
Yeah.
With his death and heart.
Well, she got the gold mine. I got the shaft. Well, they split it down the middle. And then they gave me the better half. Well, I guess this all sounds funny, but it hurts too much to laugh. She got the gold mine. I got the shaft. Oh, you think it did? I got the shaft, but I won't have to worry about the token of a hill on the board. I'm going to be carrying food stamps. Get it, Judge. I'm going to be a ha-ha. That's not funny, huh? I tell you, Judge, I don't know. I don't know.
Oh, he's right there. Tim the Boo wrote it. That's a good, yeah. That's a good there. You got the gold mine. I got the shaft.
You can
skip
me if you want to. I'll be
taking a breath at
the place.
No, I'm through. I'm recording, y'all. Oh, yeah. Just my imagination running away.
Watch out as she passes by.
John Rutland.
I'm singing like this song.
Today is July the 3rd, 2017. Live at Jerry's.